The UP government's ordinance route for education reforms is a big talking point today. Most of the provisions are not only acceptable to all, but they're badly needed, many would say. Private universities are now part of an umbrella law in Uttar Pradesh. But the one phrase used, an accountability fixed with universities, is to prevent anti-national activities. Now, no one denies that anti-national activities should not happen in a country. Why just university? But who defines what anti-national means? Who decides what act is an anti-national act? How can the university be accountable for the actions of an individual, i.e. a student? If reforms had to be brought in, then why the ordinance route? And if this is to stop the by now infamous Tukde Tukde gang in reference to the JNU incident of 2016, why bring in the ordinance now, 3 or 4 years later? What explains this urgency?
UP Private University Ordinance brought in. Universities to be held accountable for anti-national activity. What defines an anti-national activity in universities? And why didn't the government wait to pass a bill? Does the government have specific intelligence, or is this a preemptive strike against a possible Tukde Tukde gang? On Left, Right and Center, we look at the pros and cons of the new ordinance and we ask, why the urgency?
All right, I want to introduce the Deputy Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh who joins us on Left, Right and Center, Mr. Dinesh Sharma. Thank you very much for speaking to us. I want to know from you, Mr. Sharma, what is the intention behind this ordinance?
निजी विश्वविद्यालय एक्ट का सीधा सा तात्पर्य यह है कि अभी तक उत्तर प्रदेश में कोई ऐसी गतिविधि या ऐसी एक्टिविटीज़ शिक्षा के क्षेत्र में निजी विश्वविद्यालयों के लिए नहीं थी जिससे उनके कार्य संचालन में कोई किसी प्रकार का कोई नियम हो या उपनियम बना हो एक्ट के बन जाने के बाद में एक तरीके से ये निजी विश्वविद्यालयों के लिए सुरक्षा कवच के रूप में ये काम करेगा और इससे हम उनकी गतिविधियों को केंद्रित कर सकते हैं जैसे उदाहरण के तौर पर हमारा एकेडमिक कैलेंडर क्या हो हमारी परीक्षाएं कब हो हमारा रिजल्ट कब आए हमारा नया सत्र का प्रारंभ कब हो ये कुछ एकरूपताएं उसमें हैं जो इसमें इस एक्ट के अनुसार वो आपस में समन्वय स्थापित करती हैं साथ में निजी विश्वविद्यालय एक्ट का जो परफॉर्मा आता है उसमें एक विद्यार्थियों को भी शिक्षकों को भी एक एश्योरेंस मिलता है एक प्रकार का कि जो वो पढ़ाई कर रहे हैं उनकी डिग्री के प्रति सरकार भी एक उनके सहायक के रूप में काम करेगी निजी विश्वविद्यालय एक्ट पूर्णता स्वतंत्रता प्रदान करता है निजी विश्वविद्यालय को उनके कार्यकलापों में जो शैक्षिक गतिविधियां हैं उसमें किसी प्रकार का कोई हस्तक्षेप नहीं है वो अपने जो उनके नियम और उपनियम हैं उनको शामिल करते हुए जो उत्तर प्रदेश निजी विश्वविद्यालय एक्ट के प्रावधान हैं जो उसके नीतिगत निर्णय हैं उसको वो सम्मिलित करके अपना वो एक्ट अपने अपने विश्वविद्यालय में बना सकते हैं इस बात का भी प्रावधान रखा गया है इस एक्ट का मूल मंतव्य ये है कि शैक्षिक गतिविधियां बढ़ें उच्च गुणवत्ता पर शिक्षा हो और शिक्षा में एकरूपता का भाव जागृत हो बच्चों को पठन पाठन की जहां स्वतंत्रता हो वहीं जैसे नेक का बार बार उसका क्या परीक्षण है तो हमारे जो शिक्षा का स्तर है वो उससे बढ़ेगा तो ये कुछ चीज़ें इसमें जोड़ी गई हैं जिनका केवल एक ही मंतव्य है कि शैक्षिक गतिविधियां को प्रमोट किया जा सके
ठीक है चलिए मैं आपकी बात समझ गया लेकिन Mr. Dinesh Sharma, among the various provisions, there is a mention of universities being accountable and they have to file an affidavit if anti-national activity is held in their premises. Can you elaborate on what you mean by anti-national activities?
देखिए ये एक अंतर निहित तथ्य है कि चाहे वो विश्वविद्यालय हो या कोई भी संस्था हो देश के प्रति जो भी लॉयल है या देश के प्रति जो भी जवाबदेह है वो स्वयं से इस प्रकार की गतिविधियों को कभी संचालित नहीं करता है कभी आपने देखा होगा कि जो भी हमारे वहाँ पहले स्कूल में प्रार्थनाएं कराई जाती थीं स्कूल में विभिन्न प्रकार की राष्ट्रभक्ति की एक्टिविटीज अभी भी कराई जाती हैं। उनका सीधा सा मतलब होता है कि देश की एकता अखंडता को हम एक रखें, हमारा देश मजबूत बने, उसके लिए विभिन्न प्रकार के कार्यक्रमों का संचालन करें और कोई ऐसी गतिविधि ना हो जिससे हमारा देश कमजोर हो। ये अभी भी प्रत्यक्ष और अप्रत्यक्ष रूप में तमाम गतिविधियां इससे जुड़ी होती हैं। हमारा केवल मंतव्य उन्हीं गतिविधियों की तरफ हमारा इशारा भी है, वो हमारा संकेत भी है कि ऐसी गतिविधियां विश्वविद्यालय स्तर पर कतई ना हो जिनसे देश की एकता अखंडता।
नहीं, मैं समझ रहा हूं आप, आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड द ड्रिफ्ट ऑफ योर कॉन्वर्जेशन, बट हाउ डू यू डिफाइन द वर्ड्स एंटी नेशनल? व्हाट इज एंटी नेशनल? बिकॉज यू नो एनीथिंग, दिस इज लेफ्ट टू परसेप्शन, दिस इज लेफ्ट टू एन इंडिविजुअल्स आइडिया ऑफ व्हाट एंटी नेशनल इज।
देखिए, ये जो एक्ट है, एक्ट की परनियमावली भी बनती है, परनियमावलियों में इस बात का स्पष्ट संकेत होगा कि कौन सी गतिविधियां किस प्रकार की है। लेकिन एक सामान्य प्रवृत्ति है कि लोग जानते हैं कि हम जैसे कुछ विश्वविद्यालय थे जहां पर इस प्रकार के नारे लगे जो देश के विखंडन की ओर संकेत करते थे, तो इस प्रकार की गतिविधियां नहीं होनी चाहिए। यह सामान्य प्रवृत्ति है और मैं समझता हूं इसको सारे विश्वविद्यालय लिखें ना लिखें इस बात को मानने के लिए बाध्य हैं कि हम जिस देश में रहते हैं उस देश में इस प्रकार की गतिविधियां हों जो देश को मजबूत करें, राष्ट्रीय एकता को मजबूत करें।
ओके, नाउ यू सीम टू हैव मेड अ रेफरेंस, यू सीम टू बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द JNU इंसिडेंट वेरी क्लियरली, व्हिच इज नाउ इनफेमसली नोन एज द टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग, बट दैट इंसिडेंट हैपेंड इन 2016, मिस्टर शर्मा, व्हाई ब्रिंग द ऑर्डिनेंस नाउ? And that too ordinance, not a law, not a bill.
मुझे लगता है कि आपने पूरा एक्ट को ठीक से अगर पढ़ा होता तो इस प्रकार के प्रश्न नहीं होते। मुझे खुद में आश्चर्य हो रहा है कि हमने जो 100 में 99.9 जो एकेडमिक चीजों को अच्छा करने की बात की उनका जिक्र यहाँ पर नहीं हो रहा है। जिक्र केवल उस बिंदु का हो रहा है जिसमें हमने राष्ट्रीय एकता अखंडता की बात करी है। मैं समझता हूँ कि इस प्रकार की चर्चा उचित इसलिए नहीं होगी क्योंकि ये हर नागरिक का जो भारतवर्ष में रहता है उसका कर्तव्य है कि वो जो भी कृत्य करे वो राष्ट्रहित में हो और देश को मजबूत करने के लिए हो। अगर इस बात को हम लिखा पढ़त में कहते हैं तो मैं समझता हूँ ये आपत्तिजनक कहाँ से हो गया है। हमने पूरे एक्ट में आप देखेंगे कि सारी एक्टिविटीज को लिखा है, कैसे हमारी शिक्षा का संचालन हो, कैसे बच्चों को डिग्री की एक प्रामाणिकता के तौर पर डिग्री मिल सके, कैसे टीचर्स की सैलरी के बारे में, उनकी प्रोन्नत के बारे में उनको प्रोटेक्ट किया जा सके, कैसे निजी विश्वविद्यालय अपने कार्य संचालन परिषद का गठन कर सकते हैं, अपने वाइस चांसलर को अपॉइंट कर सकते हैं, कैसे उनको स्वतंत्रता हमने दी है, ये सारी चीजें ऐसा ये मॉडल एक्ट है कि पूरे देश में जिसकी चर्चा होगी, जिसकी गुणवत्ता को लेकर, जिसकी अच्छी चीजों को लेकर, उन चीजों की चर्चा हम यहां पर नहीं कर रहे हैं।
नहीं, क्यों नहीं कर रहे?
केवल एक लाइन जो लिखा है कि राष्ट्रीय एकता अखंडता को चोट ना पहुंचे, तो मैं समझता हूं ये चर्चा का विषय ही नहीं होना चाहिए कि इस प्रकार की चीज तो मानक है। आप कोई भी काम करेंगे, आपका चैनल शुरू होगा, हमारा कोई पढ़ाई का, मैं टीचर हूं तो पढ़ाने का काम शुरू होगा, तो ये अंडरस्टूड है कि हम जो भी काम करेंगे वो काम राष्ट्र के हित में हो, देश के विखंडन से संबंधित नहीं हो।
No, absolutely. Mr. Dinesh Sharma, I'll leave it there. Thank you very much for joining us. All I want to say is that my first question to you was to define what this ordinance is all about. So we want to know everything. Since this is a disputed clause, this is a clause that is inviting a lot of attention. That's why we thought of concentrating a bulk of questions. But thank you anyway for joining us. Let's quickly debate this. I've got Vivek Reddy, he's a leader of the BJP with me. Shahid Siddiqui continues to be with us. Vikram Singh is a former DGP of Uttar Pradesh, runs a university in Noida, the Noida International University. Tehsin Poonawala, political analyst, still with us. And Pankaj Agarwal is the secretary of the Private University Association of Uttar Pradesh. He's also with us. Vivek Reddy, you just heard Dinesh Sharma over there very categorically mentioning that there's nothing wrong. But he doesn't answer my question. My question is, how do you define anti-national and how can you hold universities accountable for the act of a certain or a few individuals? I mean, they are being asked to sign affidavits.
Let me come to the latter question first, as to how universities are accountable for activities within their precincts. I think, Sanket, what is very important is of late, the trend that we are witnessing is that universities have become hubs for proliferation of anti-national sentiment and anti-national activities. And we have seen this enough in JNU and in Delhi University. And I think the UP government has done a right thing by putting a quietus to this controversy.
This alleged act that you're talking about happened on the 3rd of February 2016. Why now?
Why not?
And that too an ordinance.
Let us assume.
You didn't wait for a law. You didn't wait for a bill.
Let us assume the wisdom dawned late. Let us assume the wisdom dawned late. Why not, Sanket? This is national. This is an activity which infringes upon the national unity and integrity. I think it must be brought in immediately as soon as someone sees the wisdom in it. Don't you think, Sanket, that national, anti-national activity is something that deserves to be curbed in the interest of this country? Or should it stand as an example which can be followed by others?
No, but then...
Now, what happened in
JNU? I would also like a clear definition of what is anti-national.
Was a situation where everybody was helpless.
Because at this moment, in this ordinance, it is not clear so what far as anti-national activity. An anti-national act. How do you expect universities to know what is national and what is anti-national?
Ordinance ultimately, when the ordinance ultimately receives the assent of the governor, we will know whether it has defined it. Assuming, okay. Sanket, let us take a cue from what you said. Assuming that it has not defined. But I think anti-national activity itself is enough to give the fuller meaning of this. A common dictionary meaning of a statement is taken as part of the law.
Okay.
And many a time the Supreme Court and courts which interpret acts say that this is the common dictionary meaning. For example, it is very easy to distinguish between a pro-national activity and an anti-national activity. If you take the JNU example where there was a proclamation of Tukde Tukde, Bharat Tere Tukde Tukde Hoge, I think that is clearly an anti-national activity. It is those activities that are curbed in the interest of the country. And there are some people, Sanket, let me tell you, there are some people who are waiting for a definition. And in order to see what the definition is and in order to beat that definition, and trying to still create...
No, but then one moment, Vivek Reddy, that does not justify ambiguity. Vikram Singh.
Against our children.
I will come.
We must be guarded against our children.
He runs
against the future posterity from imbibing these values.
Yes, one moment. DGP Vikram Singh, he runs a university, is directly affected as far as this new ordinance is concerned. Let's hear his view. Mr. Vikram Singh, do you think that this ordinance is ambiguous? How do you define anti-national? Weren't existing laws that already exist? You were talking just a short while ago about the various provisions of the Indian Penal Code. They already exist and they're applicable on universities as well. Why this new clause? What's the fear, Mr. Vikram Singh?
If I may be allowed to submit, that there are already existing provisions in the rule book, section 124A of the IPC, also read with section 153A of the IPC, Prevention of Insults to National Honor Act 1971, the National Security Act. Nowhere has national security been defined. In the National Security Act, subclause 2, when a person is to be detained, it is that a person's activities are prejudicial to national security and the person on the basis of a speaking order can be detained to the extent of 12 months. I would say that there are glaring examples. There are examples given in the rule book. I would say that a person desecrates the national flag, that is an anti-national activity. If one is hobnobbing with the ISIS or Indian Mujahideen cadres, then he is indulging in anti-national activities. If he is befriending ISI cohorts or ISI operatives, it is an anti-national activities. It is not exactly that everything has to be spelled out. Like obscenity, there are certain things that have been left to the imagination and judgment of the investigators and the judges, and therefore in the fitness of things. I would say that you said, why the need? The need is to reinforce and prioritize that anti-national activities will not be acceptable in universities who have benefited from the state governments by getting large chunks of lands at concessional rates, acts being passed by the state assemblies to give them the sanction to become centers of excellent academic learnings and academic excellence. If instead of that, we promote and breathe oxygen into anti-national excellence, that probably is the reason why this ordinance has been promulgated. And I would strongly recommend that we welcome it because there have been disturbing events in the past, not because that the law did not take its own course in them, but the fact remains, just to reinforce and re-emphasize the top priority that these should have in the minds
okay,
of the
sure.
registrar,
and
the vice chancellor and the governing body.
And I also have to mention over here that this is but a part of the entire ordinance. It's not the only thing. There are many other things, and I don't think anyone's disputing educational reforms. The point over here is the dispute around defining what is anti-national. If there are existing laws, why the need to reinforce? Now, the former DGP of Uttar Pradesh, who's also the vice chancellor of a university, says, yes, you need to reinforce this. Right? Tehsin Poonawalla, now I want to come to you, and then we'll go to Shahid Singh.
Tehsin. Well, for first, this is a government, both in the centre and state, who has dubious educational qualifications. Mm. Hence, they don't understand how universities must thrive and students must thrive. And I will elaborate that point further with examples. In my home city of Pune, Savarkar's relatives run an organization called Abhinan, run an organization which even today on its website says that the Indian constitution must be changed. India must not remain the country it is, and then the tricolor, because the honorable former DGP spoke about tricolor, should become a saffron flag. Is that anti-national or no? That organization continues to thrive. Their people were arrested for attempting to cause a bomb blast in my city of Pune. Yet, it is the false equivalence drawn of students may or may not have shouted slogans where their government is in power and they've not been able to complete the investigation. But both of them are equally wrong. The fact, the point that I'm trying to make is the definition of anti-national as the DGP ran away is not being put and not answered. It is not being put. Now, if I were to in university as a student say, hey, Yogi Adityanath or Ajay Bisht is a pathetic administrator, is not qualified to be chief minister, that will be branded by DGPs like him as anti-national and say, oh, but the court will release him, as we saw in the case of Pankaj Kanojia. We've seen this administration, this government coming down heavily on what are just rights to protest. By taking away students' rights to protest. I am not making a false equivalence with slogans. Those slogans are wrong. Your government did not act. But at least you cannot take away the rights of students to protest. This ordinance also says there will be no protests in universities. Who is the government to allow that to happen? That's my fundamental right.
Hmm. And so
my
fundamental I don't right think occur. The ordinance talks about no well, protests well, in universities.
Well, the circular that's come out has said there will be no protests on this. This is a further step on this.
Okay. But even that, by the way, there are many universities that do not allow protests. They do not even allow the formation of student unions.
Which again
it's
is
also
a larger
a part of
which
the
is
university.
Why I'm saying that taking away rights of students slowly by slowly you're chipping away. Okay. And I go back, is saying Ajay Bisht is not qualified to be chief minister anti-national? No. Forget Ajay Bisht, is saying the Narendra Modi government is not qualified to be a government in India. Tomorrow they'll say that is anti-national.
No, but this is a fear. That's not the point.
It's been used.
It's been a fear that you okay, well, Shahid Siddiqui. Very quickly. Shahid Siddiqui now. Shahid Siddiqui, do you think this is a way, a strong arm tactic?
Yeah.
Being used by the government against universities?
I just don't understand why it is the priority of UP government. Because already laws exist. Are they trying to say that there could be anti-national activities in universities now or in the past? No, they could not be. They cannot be. So laws are very much there. Laws are in place. Where was the need to emphasize? You want to make JNU false incident into a huge national issue and you want a priority and you want to become ordinance on that, I think is misplaced. It's only to really divert the attention from basic other issues. The priority should have been UP is facing a drought. That should be the priority. That should be the focus. But focus is on something else. Yes, of course, you need to streamline the universities, the private universities, which are money-making enterprises, which are, in fact, the government should be more concerned about the government institutions, government universities, improving their condition, improving their standards, instead of going the private university way, which are basically money-making machines, which are...
No, all the more reason, Mr. Shahid Siddiqui, that the government can turn around and say, this is the reason why we are getting...
Poor.
This is the reason why we're getting an umbrella act.
No, but that is not happening.
To govern them.
No, but that is not happening. That is not happening. Hmm. That is not happening. The freedom of which has been given to the universities by the past government as well as this government. Lot of politicians are involved in running these universities. Lot of ex-bureaucrats are involved in running these universities. And these universities are taking the young people for a ride all over the country, including Uttar Pradesh. And now unnecessarily you are bringing an issue of you know, anti-national. Who is anti-national? Today, anybody who speaks against the government is called anti-national. Anybody who raises a slogan against the government is called anti-national.
Exactly.
So what happens? You can question any teacher, any professor, any student.
Okay, Pankaj Agarwal.
That is not the way to run a university.
Shahid Siddiqui, I'll come back to you.
There should be freedom of expression, freedom of debate.
Shahid as well as Vivek,
debate in the university,
I'm going to come back to you.
Minds cannot fly. They cannot be...
Can I just come
Yeah, let me... I have to introduce Mr. Pankaj Agarwal, who is the secretary of the Private University Association of Uttar Pradesh. He is also with us. Pankaj, you have heard the concerns that have been raised. Now, I want to know from you, because you are, if we were to believe, an aggrieved party as far as this ordinance is concerned. What is your view? Do you find anything objectionable in the order? Tell me honestly.
No, as far as, you know, when this... honestly, I'll tell you, you know, when this ordinance was to be made, you know, a lot of discussions had gone, has taken place with the government and with us. And based on those discussions, you know, our main intent was that the autonomy of a university, because in any academic institution, you know, every academic institution runs with a different agenda. You know, some focuses on maybe mass comm, some focuses on engineering, some focuses on management. So every university has to run with a different agenda. That is why, you know, if we look at the bigger perspective also, different universities are known for their different courses. So that was being taken care of. And if we talk about just this agenda of the anti-national thing, if we draw a direct analogy between, say, ragging and this anti-national thing, so harassment of any student was already punishable under law. But then, even then, you know, an anti-ragging thing was made, and the students were sensitized towards it, you know, so that it does not take place in the universities. So I think it's about, you know, what I can think of, although we also need some clarity from the government, and I'm sure we are going to get it in the course of time, that, you know, they're trying to curb the line, you know, which is being crossed in the name of freedom of expression in such activities, students' activities, because, you know, as a student, they actually have the freedom to express themselves, and that is where I think the government wants to tell them and educate them. But what I feel, it should be better done during the you know, from the college days, when we are into primary education, that we are talked about, we are being told about what the nation is all about. And once we are sensitized at that level, I don't think so these kind of problems are going to arise when we grow up and enter
a university. Pankaj, from what I gather, from what you have said, I'm not being able to understand your position on this issue clearly. You say that there is ambiguity, and perhaps it'll help if you get clarity from the government. At the same time, training to not indulge in these activities must start at a very junior level. Is that what you're saying?
Absolutely. Yeah, that is exactly what I mean to say. You know, the bigger solution to this problem is if we start at the school level.
But then you also maintain that there is ambiguity. You do not know what exactly this ordinance means, or
Absolutely.
This clause in the ordinance means. Interesting. Vikram Singh, very quickly, I'll come back to you.
No problem.
See, these are people who are directly aggrieved, yes, or affected. Yes. Vikram Singh, do you think the government needs to clarify what it means by anti-national?
Of course, there will be detailed guidelines on how to... There are certain loose ends that will have to be tied up. There have to be detailed guidelines from the government, refresher courses and workshops for the vice chancellors and the registrars to tell them where the dividing line is and where the line of demarcation is. There cannot be any grey areas. Look, there is a situation when a student from the NCR University went and joined the cadres of Kashmir militants. I would say that this is not something that you can brush underneath the carpet. It has to be taken very seriously, and everything that is going around and the vitriolic atmosphere that we are in. Of course, my due regards to Mr. Tehsin Poonawalla, of course, defeat can never be a very pleasant thing, and that impacts the thinking and the wiring of the mind. But at the same time, we need to see things in their true perspective. It is not for me to skirt around the issues, but the fact remains that a few things are left undefined for the simple reason that it is on the experience of the investigator and the wisdom of the court to say whether it was anti-national or not.
Okay.
Detailed guidelines are coming, and there are court cases which give you clarity what is anti-national and what is not.
Singh Saab, you continuously spoke about
very quickly,
two quick points. You continuously spoke about Kashmir and other of such elements. I wish you would have also included Abhinav Bharat and mingling with Abhinav Bharat, part of the Sangh Parivar larger, whose objectives have been well defined. But I don't want to get into that debate. I want to ask Vivek Reddy a simple question. Vivek Reddy, there have been deaths in Bihar. If as a student in a Uttar Pradesh university, I were to say the healthcare in my country is really bad.
Okay.
Am I anti-national?
What is the priority?
Or am I national?
Okay.
Am I anti-national? Or am I not? Because you will
no,
come
no,
out and
course,
say, no,
no
he will come out and say, you're criticizing the country. Are look, Pakistan.
No, one moment. One moment. This is a fear. Of course, you're not.
But they put.
He was talking about the healthcare.
He put Prashant in jail. No, for freedom of speech.
The merits of those cases.
They are saying don't criticize the country.
Vivek.
Please.
No. Talking about the healthcare
debate.
No,
criticizing
this country.
My country. Criticizing
Sanket,
my country.
Let me tell you.
Yes or no, I'm running out of time.
This is a grave issue. Whenever the national security is threatened, whenever universities are used
it's
to
it's threatened with slogans, not with bomb blasts by
nation.
Abhinav Bharat.
I think the nation
slogans
should have
threatened
zero
the country's
tolerance.
Integrity.
I think the nation
and not
should
bomb
have zero
blasts by Abhinav Bharat.
Hold on and listen. Hold on and listen.
No, hold
okay,
on.
Okay,
no,
one moment. I need to come in here.
The gravity
order,
of the issue.
Please.
I think you must first listen.
One moment.
Let me tell you one thing.
As well as
you are the most irresponsible person when you make these statements.
We on NDTV do not encourage.
Don't play
shouting
around
matches.
With national security, Tehsil Punawala.
Let us please
your
have a civilized conversation. In any case, I've run out of time. Gentlemen, I've run out of time in this discussion. We'll carry this forward because certainly we need clarity and we will get clarity and there will be more, plenty of opportunities to debate this. Thank you so much for watching this special broadcast. News and updates will continue on the other side.